speaking of Texas, where there happens to be a space center, there is a brand new documentary on News Talk about the moon landings. Let's have a listen.
We are still go with Apollo 11. 30 seconds and counting. Astronauts report it feels good. T-minus 25 seconds. 20 seconds and counting. T-minus 15 seconds. Guidance is internal. 12, 11, 10, 9. Ignition sequence start. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. All engine running. Liftoff.
Shane, talk to us about picking up some dust.
Yeah, picking up some dust. Available now to listen. Shameless plug here, newstalk.com/documentary on News Talk. Or if you get me on Twitter at ShaneHannon01, you'll see my pinned tweet there has a link to it. This has been a labor of love for me, Eoin, over the last couple of years. You know that I'm a massive space geek. Probably inspired by my dad when he was 13. He talked about growing up in Dunmore in County Galway, getting up in the middle of the night on the night of July 20th into the early hours of July 21st, 1969, and watching Neil and Buzz take those first steps on the moon in Apollo 11. And I'm sure many Irish people got up in the middle of the night and remember where they were to watch that. And really an incredible time. And as I spoke about last night, it's the technology that we maybe have in our iPhones today that got them there, which makes it even more extraordinary. But I went on this trip to Texas, and I really appreciated your segue there, Eoin. That's probably the highlight of any of our careers on Off the Ball. But I visited Mission Control in Houston, in Texas, and I didn't know how it would impact me, because I did what's called the Level 9 tour, where you pay a bit extra and you get the VIP kind of treatment. You get to walk on the floor of the old Mission Control Room, which is where you'll see them all celebrating and the American flags and the cigars after the moon landings. And I actually got quite emotional being there, because they showed a video up on screen and gave you a sense of what it must have been felt like in that room at that time in 1969. And really, it was powerful. And look, I had fun on this Texas trip. The interviews for this documentary took me from Texas to New Mexico to Chicago, the housing estate in Coolock that I mentioned on last night's show that is named in honor of the Apollo astronauts. But I really embraced the Texas experience. I went to a Willie Nelson concert on the 4th of July, drank some cold beers, wore a cowboy hat as I drove around, and listened to Darius Rucker, Wagon Wheel. So you'll know Nathan Carter's version is the mainstream version at the moment. Darius Rucker is the hipster version. So I went full Texas. Really enjoyed the experience, but interviewed a number of different people. One of them was actually someone who would have been in that room in Mission Control in Houston, Jerry Griffin. In this clip here, you'll hear he, I guess, sums up why the name Picking Up Some Dust was picked by me for the documentary.
60 seconds. Lights on. Down 2.5. Forward. 40 feet down, 2.5. Picking up some dust.
Picking up some dust. And when he said that, it still sends chills when I think of that. It dawned on me, we have two guys in this spacecraft with an engine that's hitting the lunar surface and blowing dust out. And I said, we're gonna land.
30 feet, 2.5 down, straight shadow, 4 forward. 4 forward, drift into the right a little. 2.5. 30 seconds forward. Drift. Ready? Contact light. Okay, engine stop. ATA at a descent. Host control, both auto descent, engine command override off. Engine arm off. 413 is in.
We copy you down, Eagle.
Listen, Tranquility Base here. The Eagle has landed.
Roger, Tranquility. We copy you on the ground. You got a bunch of guys about to turn blue. We're breathing again. Thanks a lot.
Brilliant. Absolutely class. Explain for people maybe who weren't listening to the show last night, the Irish links.
Yeah, a load of different Irish links. I mentioned the housing estate in Coolock. So it's called the Woodville Estate, but it was named, there are streets still today named in Coolock in this estate. You know, Armstrong Walk, Aldrin Walk, Eagle Park, Tranquility Grove, Apollo Way. There was a moonrock given to Ireland by the Americans as well in 1969, lost in a fire, unfortunately, at Dunsink Observatory in 77, which we talk about in the documentary. And it's sitting somewhere in a dump in Dunsink. But loads of different Irish links. And look, I mentioned I interviewed a number of Apollo astronauts for this, and I've actually been lucky enough over the years to have met seven of the 12 guys who walked on the moon between 69 and 72. Only four of them are still with us. So a lot of varied personalities. Edgar Mitchell, who I spoke to in 2012, he passed away 4 years later. He believes in UFOs. He actually said, I happen to be in on the fact that we have been visited on this planet and that there is a cover-up. This is a guy who walked on the moon.
Nice.
But a lot of interesting stories. Buzz Aldrin, a lot of people know Neil Armstrong was the first on the moon. Buzz Aldrin was actually the first person to urinate on the moon. So as he was coming down the ladder, they had a setup where they could pee if they wanted inside their spacesuit. And as Buzz Aldrin was coming down the ladder, looking at this really emotional scenery in front of him, he decided to do a number one or a number two. Which is it? Number one. Yeah, number one. Definitely a number one. So that was a little tidbit about Apollo that people might not have been aware of. But I just wanted to play you one last clip. This is my own hero is Captain Gene Cernan, the Apollo 17 commander, last man to walk on the moon. This is a guy who, when I interviewed him, you know, spoke about how he's just a normal person. He happened to walk on the moon, but he told me, you know, I bleed when I cut myself. I put my trousers on one leg at a time. This is a guy whose handwriting I have tattooed on my ribcage. Such is my obsession with Captain Gene Cernan. He and Harrison Schmitt walked on the moon in Apollo 17. And this is just a little clip of when they discovered orange soil on the surface of the moon.
During one of the moonwalks, Jack suddenly announced that he'd discovered orange soil. Bright orange soil on the surface of the moon. Now, in the TV cameras, we could see that the soil was orange. It wasn't the bland grey of the moon. But when we saw that, when we heard him say orange soil and we saw the TV with orange soil, all the scientists jumped up at once and all the tables with all the maps for planning the moonwalks were scattered around the room. I have never before or since seen a group of scientists go so completely crazy.
Oh, hey! Wait a minute. What? Where are the reflections? I've been fooled once. There is orange soil! I see it. It's all over. Orange! Don't hold it till I see it. I've stirred it up with my feet. Hey, it is! I can see it from here. It's orange. Wait a minute, let me put my visor up. It's still orange. Sure it is. Crazy. Orange.
So newstalk.com/documentary on Newstalk, Shane, is where to get it.
Exactly, you'll get it there. My younger sister Rachel was involved in sound design as well, mastered by Neil Kavanagh, and Broadcasting Authority of Ireland were good enough to give me funding for this one. So yeah, newstalk.com/documentary on Newstalk.